Hey guys, welcome to Lone Tree Milsim. My name is Scott and today we're going to be taking a look at the Airsoft Innovations Cyclone Grenades. These were sent to me by Airsoft Innovations, so I'm very grateful. They sent me three so that I could use in-game and get a really good comprehensive review over them. They also sent me extra spoons and pins and some propane adapters and stuff like that, so I'm very grateful for all the products they sent me. But I will give you guys an honest opinion on these grenades. And I'll go over the pros and cons, and I'll show you guys some features, some gameplay footage from it, where we actually use these grenades in-game, and also how to set these up, because they can be quite tricky. But first, I'll go over the overview of it. They are $40, they're quite cheap, compared to their older brother, which is the Tornado grenade, which is about $100. So these are a little bit more affordable, so you can get a couple of these for the same price as the other one. They are quite small, and they are a little bit of a pain to set up, but they are pretty neat, and they can be used pretty fast. Some of the main features of it is, you can load it up with green gas or propane. It holds about 144 BBs, and they spray out about 220 feet per second, I believe. I would use 0.2s in these, as they are a little bit faster at coming out, and they are a little bit better at clearing the room. I'll go over what you get in a box when you order these. Comes in a really neat box. It comes with the head of the grenade, the spoon, the main body of the grenade, the base, obviously, and the pin. And it also comes with these covers that you can put on the side to help identify which grenade is yours. You can write your name on it, you put your phone number on it, whatnot. Also comes with an orange and a black one. And they also come with two pretty cool patches. So everyone loves patches, right? These grenades also come with some oil, which helps lubricate them and keep them running at top efficiency. But I'll go into how do you set it up. So we'll go to that right now. All right, so I'm gonna be showing you guys how to set up your Cyclone grenades. Now, first I'll just quickly show you here the cool patches that you get with it. This one here says Frag to Win, Airsoft Innovations. And then this little guy here is just an awesome picture of the grenade. So I know you guys, a lot of you guys like to collect patches, so there's some pretty cool ones that come with these. This here is the main body of the grenade. This one has the orange identifying tape, whatever you want to call it, on it. This here is the head of the grenade, and then this is the base. So I'll show you what you got to do first. Okay, so you're going to take the head of the grenade, and if you notice on the bottom, there is this gold piece here sticking out, okay? And what you wanna do is you're gonna wanna push on something hard, like a table like this, and push it up. So this head over here gets pushed up. And you're gonna pull it forward so that it locks at an angle like that, see? So now it should be flush on the bottom and at an angle on the top, okay? Then you're gonna take your spoon and you're gonna fit that little thing right there, right in that gap to hold it in place, okay? So this, when this hits a hard surface, that moves forward and then that drops down and it hits the thing down there, which releases the gas, which causes the grenade to go. Then you can put your pin in. Pin's pretty cool how it works with its locking mechanism. I'll put it right in to show you. Slide it right through both ends and then you just push down over and it locks into place. So now the top of your grenade is ready to go. Grab your base. And then there's these two little grooves. I don't know how you can see that on the camera, but and then there are two little notches that are in here, and you just line them up, and you just twist, and it'll lock into place, like so, okay? You can see over here, that's where the BBs come out, when the grenade is set off. What you do here, on the bottom, you can see that this is raised, and it moves a little bit. You can put your grenade oil, after every few uses, down in this container down in here where the gas is going to sit to provide lubrication. But to fill it up with gas, you're going to push down on this until it is flush with the base of the grenade, like so. You'll take your propane, okay, like so, and then you'll just insert it in there and fill it up. Thing is, I don't know how much to put in there or how much it can hold, so I just put, you know, just as much as I feel comfortable. So I fill that up. Then you can take your BBs, and you fill these channels. Now this will hold 144 BBs, I believe. And you can just fill up all these channels as full as you can up to the top. And then You're gonna grab your base. Now this is where it gets tricky. And I feel like with all those three grenades that I have, it was always the hardest to do this on the first try. Now you're gonna wanna look at the manual when you're doing this yourself. Gives you a clearer picture of what to look for. But if you look close, I'm gonna try to focus here. I don't know how well it looks. But anyways, it's not doing so good. But there is a little notch right up here, which lines up with a little indent on here. And you're gonna line those up, and then you're gonna push down, hopefully. Line those up. Push down on all sides, and then twist to lock, okay? So now your grenade is ready to go. It is armed. They say give it 15 minutes from when you fill it up with propane for the propane to settle, for it to be most effective. But yeah, once that's done, it is ready to go. It is a pain to get set up the first few times, but once you learn how to do it, it becomes a system, and then you just have these grenades ready to go. You can set them up before the game or the night before is what I usually do, and just pop it in your vest like so. I just stick mine right in here, like so, and then you are ready to go and throw some BBs into some rooms. So I'm gonna show you guys some gameplay footage.
That's one. That almost killed us. Other corner.
In there.
Okay, stop, put a grenade in. Ready?
All right, so now that we've looked at how to set it up and some gameplay footage of it, I'm gonna go over the pros and cons of it, okay? First off, I'd like to say that I love the pins on these. These are like my favorite things. I love the locking mechanism on them. They even work with your old Thunderbee grenades, which is great because I always found myself accidentally pulling the pin on these Thunderbee grenades and them going off accidentally. So these work great in both. They hold it in place and they will not go off. They will not, you can mess around with these things and they will not come off, which is great. A problem though with it is once you pull the pin, right, the spoon is not connected to the grenade at all. So you gotta remember to take the spoon with you and so that you can actually throw the grenade, because if you chuck the grenade with the spoon, you're probably never gonna see this guy again. And you don't want to have to buy replacements and stuff, and this is kind of important. It does have a hole here, which you could probably use to tie a string to the spoon or tie a string to the grenade somehow. But that is one feature that I do not like. Also, they are a little bit awkward to fit in your existing grenade pouches and stuff like that. The ones that I just showed you there in the setup for my tan, these tan ones that have a complete covering around, those work okay. They'll hold them in place, but they are tricky to get out, which is a problem. But on the back here of my vest, this is a grenade pouch that has a gap right into it, right? And these fit great for Thunderbee grenades as they're easy to get out and they hold pretty tight in. These Cyclone grenades, they fit in there, but like not very well. I'd be scared that, I didn't run one in here because I was scared that it would fall out, so I actually kept it in my back of my pouch. But be note of that, if you have these type of grenade holders, they are probably not your best bet. These would be good in a bag if you kept them on you, or a big pouch to put these grenades in, or the back of your backpack. That is one problem with them. And also we found whenever we were using them actually at the field, we had some inconsistency issues. They worked about 70 to 80% of the time whenever we put them into a room. Sometimes we would chuck it against a hard Connex wall and the pin wouldn't set, and so it wouldn't go off. We had that happen a couple times. Or it would go off and some BBs wouldn't come out. Not sure why, maybe we were using the wrong type of BBs for it, they were too heavy or something like that. We did have some inconsistency issues, but overall, they did work every single time that most of the time that we threw them into rooms. And they were pretty cool. I mean, it's nothing more thrilling than pulling a grenade out and just chucking it in a room and just hearing it just explode, and BBs come flying out and everywhere, and they are pretty cool. And you guys can see from the footage that we did use them quite a bit. But that is a problem, is they are inconsistent. There are the times where you'll like, oh no, crap, they're coming up the stairs, something like that, and you'll chuck them downstairs and they won't go off, you know? And they are a pain to set up as well, but Overall, for the price, they're not bad. And the fact that you can reuse these a lot and they give you everything that you need for them is really good. Their website's also great. They have, like, you know, everything that you need. You have the propane adapters. If you don't have one, you can get extra spoons and stuff like that, and extra coverings. You can get ones that are just completely blank, so you can write your name on it and phone number and whatever you want on there. You can tell these are really well made, but they do have that inconsistency issue, which are a problem, but I'm grateful for them, and I will use them in other games, though. They are really handy for close quarters and buildings and stuff like that. They don't hurt a crazy ton, so if you're worried about hurting people with these, they won't. Just make sure you wear eye protection, obviously. And if you guys are interested in picking these up, be sure to go pick them up. They're available at most airsoft retailers, and they do run for about $40, which is not bad at all. So be sure to go do that. I hope you guys enjoyed this review of these Airsoft Innovations Cyclone Grenades. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope to see you guys later. Hey guys, if you are looking to buy a Lone Tree Milsim t-shirt, we finally have them for sale. You can find them on eBay. I'll put a link in the description, or I'm just going to put a URL right here. They run for $20. You can get them in green with this awesome white writing, and also tan with black writing. So if you guys are interested in picking up one of these shirts, be sure to head over to eBay and pick them up. It's a great way to support us, and also proudly wear a Lone Tree Milsim shirt. Thanks guys for watching, and I hope you guys have a great day. Thanks.